and welcome to Let's Read with LabbyDragon. I know, I was supposed to review that book about martial arts on Mars, but you won't believe what I found. Okay, if you read the video title, you might believe. This is a My Little Pony picture book, obviously. But it's not just any old MLP book, it's the Runaway Rainbow, based on the G3 direct-to-video release. As you may or may not know, I LP'd the Game Boy Advance adaptation of this, which you should watch because that game is hilarious, but finish this video first. Now, this is a third generation product, so those of you who became fans because of Friendship is Magic may find yourselves confused. I'll address the issues as they come up. Starting with the cover. This unicorn is Rarity. Yes, before she looked like this, she looked like this. Also, the full title is My Little Pony Crystal Princess, The Runaway Rainbow. It's like they're trying to stretch the attention span of the target audience to its limit. And no, I don't know why the little yellow birds have crowns and are hitched to a cart they clearly couldn't pull. And these tiny winged ponies? They're called breezies. We'll talk about them later. Oh my god, all of the blank flanks! I think the idea is for kids to be able to color them in as their favorite ponies, but I find it a little unnerving. Also, this title page is a total spoiler for the end of the story, because, look, on the very first page of the actual story, Rarity has this stubby little horn, but on the title page, she had a full-sized horn. Way to go, guys! Alright, time to actually read this thing. The unicorns were busy preparing for the rainbow celebration in Unicornia. Unicornia is basically proto-Canterlot, except only the unicorns live there. Yeah, in this story, the ponies seemed really segregated. Princess Rarity had a starring role. With a magic wand, she would help make the first rainbow of the season. She just had to learn how. "Rarity, please pay attention," her teacher cheerily said. Yes, this is Cheerily, who used to look like this.
Actually, this is the model they're using here. Styling Cheerily, who is inexplicably a unicorn.
Rarity wasn't very interested in the lessons, but she did like twirling the magic wand. Rarity waved the wand above her head. "Be careful," cried Cheerily. And it was too late. In a flash of sparks, Rarity was gone. Oh, dear. Those breezies are really poorly drawn. I guess now is as good a time as ever to explain what they are.
Breezies are basically what happens when someone in the Hasbro boardroom for thinking up new ponies says, "What if we found a way to combine fairies and ponies?" And someone else says, "Wait, no! Dragonflies combined with ponies makes way more sense!" Neither of these things actually make sense. But I do think the toys are super cute.
These really deformed-looking drawings in this book? Not so much. Thump. The breezies were quite surprised when Rarity dropped out of nowhere. "Welcome to Breezy Blossom," said Tralala. "What's that bump on your head?" I think it's pretty well implied in the Runaway Rainbow that the breezies have met some ponies, but they've never seen a unicorn. I'm really conflicted about the way this particular story seems to create these social strata that just don't exist in other third-generation stories. I've always felt My Little Pony was about accepting those who are different, without actually having to say so. But enough of my theories on the deeper meaning of the mere existence of colorful plastic ponies. "That's not a bump," said Rarity. "That's my horn. I'm a unicorn. Verity explained what happened. "Maybe the ponies will know what to do," said Zipsy. "We'll take you with us to the Ponyville Rainbow Celebration." "But I make the first rainbow of the season," said Rarity. "If I'm not back in Unicornia in time, there won't be any rainbows anywhere, even in Ponyville." And this is where I'm convinced Lauren Faust did more research than just her nostalgia for My Little Pony. She took little throwaways like, "I have to make the rainbow," and thought, "What if the ponies make all of the weather?" The result? Pure genius. Oh, hi, Earth Pony Rainbow Dash. I'm sure you all know that Rainbow Dash wasn't always such a high flyer, or so full of tood.
Boo!
Rarity followed her new friends to Ponyville. "Welcome, Breezies," said Rainbow Dash. "Who is your new friend?" "That's Rarity. She fell out of the sky," Tra-la-la explained. "And she makes rainbows with a magic wand." "I'm from Unicornia," Rarity said. "I must get back home for the rainbow celebration there. Do you know the way?" "I've never heard of Unicornia, but maybe Spike has," said Rainbow Dash. "Follow me."
How has she never heard of Unicornia? If they supposedly control the rainbows, oh, and have a big old castle. Not to mention, later we find out that Unicornia is only a few days walking away from Ponyville. There's no way I believe they haven't heard of each other.
This is Spike. He's orange and blue and kind of like Twilight in this iteration. And in the Game Boy Advance game, there's a pinball game in a study. That's completely random information. The ponies in Rarity went to visit Spike, the wise little dragon. Reading from a big book, Spike told a story about unicorns and how they make the rainbows that brighten the skies over Ponyville and everywhere else. "You are a very special unicorn, Rarity," said Spike. "If we don't get you back to Unicornia, there won't be any rainbows this season."
"No rainbows," cried Rainbow Dash. "We have to bring Rarity home."
Look at the still they chose for this page. You're supposed to be all worried about the rainbows. Or maybe that's just Dash. But still, they're all smiling like nothing's going on. Also, say hi to Minty.
She was one of the most popular G3 ponies, and I've always found it strange that she wasn't in the Core 7. Scootaloo? Tularula? You two are cute and all, but you weren't more marketable than Minty. I think she was passed over, though, because personality-wise, she's too much like Pinkie Pie. And honestly, Pinkie Pie has been the franchise's cash cow for a while. That's why they wouldn't let Lauren Faust not use her.
Speaking of, that is Pinkie Pie in the corner there. Oh, wow. The art quality has just dropped a lot. I'm not sure if these are just stills from the DVD or if they're redrawn scenes, but the art style's slipping with the distance there. The group set out on the journey. Over mountains, across fields, and past rivers, the travelers walked on and on. Minty noticed that the pretty colors in Rainbow Dash's hair were starting to fade. They had to hurry. Spike led the group onward. Pinkie Pie was worried they were lost, but Spike trusted his map. Rarity wandered off to play with butterflies. She chased them to the edge of a cliff and was just about to catch one.
Splash!
Rarity fell into the river. Yes, this Rarity isn't very smart.
No, that's not it. I think she's meant to be incredibly young, and probably with ADD to boot.
Also, where has the green stripe in her tail gone? Not to mention the purple stripe that has been missing for half the book. Kids notice these things, you know. Minty and Pinkie Pie tried to pull her out, but they fell in too. Luckily, the Breezies came to the rescue. They flew down to the water and lifted their friends up to safety, one by one.
Hooray for the Breezies, cheered the ponies. That night, the travelers built a cozy campfire. As the rest of the group began to doze off, Rarity saw a shooting star. Tomorrow was the rainbow celebration. Oh no, Rarity whispered. What if we don't get back in time? What if there are no rainbows this year? It will be all my fault. Rarity shook everyone awake. We have to keep going, she said. Oh, hi. More ponies who are in this shot on the DVD, but until now have had no mention in this picture book. I sure hope I remember you from the toy line. I don't. As the tired group trudged along in the dark, Rarity heard a rustle in the bushes. It was Cheerily. Rarity had never been happier. All she wanted was to go home. Cheerily was relieved to see that Rarity still had her magic wand. As Rarity's old and new friends looked on, she waved the wand in the special princess twirl to call the crystal carriage, which I can only assume Cheerily just taught her how to do, because if she could do it the whole time and never thought to...
Ah!
Everyone climbed in for a ride through the sky to Unicornia. Oh, poor Rainbow Dash. Wait, why is it only Dash's mane that's affected by this? Does it literally have to be every single color of the rainbow to be affected by this no rainbow things? How does this even make sense? Dash's mane turns bluish-white if there are no rainbows? I don't understand how these things are connected, and in what way. Why are you bringing me so many complicated questions, Runaway Rainbow? You're just a children's picture book. Thanks, Dash. I needed that. Time was running out for Rarity to make the first rainbow. As soon as the carriage landed, the unicorns ran to the castle. All across the land, rainbow-striped colors were fading. They had to make the rainbow. Fast! Oh, no, cried Cheerily. The rainbow colors are gone. We've lost our chance. Rarity looked around the dull room full of sad faces. She knew she had to do something. We have to try, she said. We can't just give up. The unicorns put their horns together. At first, nothing happened. Suddenly, Rarity's pink horn grew longer and started to glow. Why? Why did Rarity's horn grow? Is this some sort of coming-of-age thing I don't know about? Like the old-fashioned unicorn version of getting your cutie mark? Crap! I'm asking questions again! Then Cheerily's purple horn began to glow, too. It's working! Cried Rainbow Dash. A flash of light from the unicorn's horns flew up to the ceiling and through the castle dome. Okay. No. I have to nitpick at this, too. It's supposed to be some kind of special celebration day, even in Ponyville. So why do they look so surprised to see a rainbow? And I'm assuming that this is rainbow physics in this world, because they're made with magic instead of naturally occurring refracted light. Ribbons of color filled the sky. They raced around Unicornia and out over the land, even as far as Ponyville. As all the beautiful colors returned, Cheerily told Rarity, "You are a true unicorn princess." Everyone clapped and cheered. "I couldn't have done it without all of you," said Rarity. "I promise that for as long as I am princess, there will be rainbows every day as a gift for my wonderful friends."
Actually, how did Rarity become princess? Was it the horn thing? Is it a bloodline thing? Do they trade out every year so everyone gets a turn? Which I wouldn't put past this generation of MLP. This is the generation that gave us every pony as a princess. No, really. That's a thing that happened. As far as G3 is concerned, every pony is a legit princess.
As an added bonus, the inside back cover is a coloring page of the front cover, wherein Rarity gets left as a blank flank. I still find that creepy. that's the silliness that is My Little Pony, the Runaway Rainbow. As you can see from the back, there's a lot of these My Little Pony storybooks out there, and I wish I had more, but I don't right now. Yet, there is something in the future lineup for the show that you might have some interest in. Spider-Man. Yeah, that's eventually on Let's Read with LabbyDragon.
And darlings, the first rainbow of the season is the most beautiful rainbow of the year.
Pink, the sunrise is pink, and so is a rose. A buttercup glows, all yellowy colors curve in a line. Together they make the rainbow shine. Blue, the ocean is blue, the sky is blue too. The sunset is truly purpley colors gather on high, all making
Oh, hi, missing lines.
And I'm assuming these are rainbow physics in this world, because they're made from magic and not naturally reflected light. Refracted. Fuck.